Peace talks have yet again failed to bring an end to the bloody conflict in Ukraine. In the past 13 days, more than 1.7 million refugees have fled the country, among them an Australian-Ukrainian family reunited after a terrifying escape from the war zone.
In the hellish human corridor near the border with Poland, Lilia, who's married to an Australian man, and their 9-year-old daughter Samira are at breaking point. Their journey to escape fighting near Odessa in the south has been long and terrifying, and she's desperate to see her father. We sent him a video message to let him know they're safe.
Okay.
He's coming soon.
And then join the long queue, a bottleneck of shattered, fraught faces.
My friends are there.
Your friends are still there?
No.
She's freezing and tired and scared. They all are.
So after 5 days of travelling, trains, three different buses and then walking, they're nearly there. You can see the queue is still just enormous. You ready to cross the border?
Of course.
Yeah.
At the final checkpoint, we say goodbye. They don't know if or when they'll return to Ukraine. It's 10 more hours on buses and trains to reach Warsaw, where father and husband Warwick has flown in from Brisbane, and it's an anxious wait until the girls arrive. Exhausted, relieved, finally safe in the arms of family. They're all ready to get some sleep.
It's been quite the ordeal, hasn't it?
Yep.
And leave the war behind.
Hello, Australia!
They're the lucky ones. Kharkiv is a city in ruins. Hundreds of people cram its train station, hoping to make the same escape. While in Irpin, near the capital, the elderly are helped along a precarious plank. 2,000 people managed to leave the besieged city after 8 locals were killed trying to get out yesterday. Moscow offered humanitarian corridors out of Kyiv, Mariupol, Sumy and Kharkiv, but on one chilling condition. The escape routes were to Russia or its staunch ally, Belarus, an offer Ukraine rejected as immoral.
Evacuation routes into the arms of the country that is currently destroying yours is a nonsense.
Ukraine says shelling once again prevented safe evacuation in many areas. Russia has its own version of events.
Ukrainian radicals and neo-Nazis who are holding hostage whole towns and cities and are making use of citizens as a human shield.
The Black Sea city of Mykolaiv under heavy fire. This resident says he's filming the damage so the world will understand. The Kremlin claims all this could be stopped in a moment, releasing 4 demands ahead of a third round of unsuccessful peace talks.
We want to see a demilitarized Ukraine. We want to have guarantees that the neutral status of Ukraine is fixed in the constitution.
Demanding Ukraine acknowledge Crimea as Russian territory and separatist regions of Donetsk and Luhansk as independent states.
President Putin to start talking, start the dialogue instead of living in the informational bubble.
On a day of frantic diplomacy, Australia stepped up its response.
These are sanctions on individuals particularly who have engaged in the dissemination of disinformation and propaganda.
President Biden hosting a call with the leaders of France, Germany and the UK, indicating they'll also increase sanctions.
Plusieurs semaines et plusieurs mois.
We want to do it through international pressure, Emmanuel Macron said, to avoid a world war with nuclear power. Acknowledging a negotiated end to the conflict isn't likely anytime soon.
We've been living under sanctions for quite a long time, so we have nearly got accustomed to that practice.
9-year correspondent Amelia Adams is in Lviv for us this evening. Amelia, it's a city that's being pushed to its limits.
Oh, it's reached its limits. Peter, the mayor is begging international organisations to help. 50,000 people are churning through the train station where we are every day, and hundreds of thousands more are staying. They're displaced and they need food, they need medicine, they need warm clothes, accommodation. It is absolute mayhem. And as Putin's army tightens the noose on the capital and the south and the east, another wave of refugees is coming. And of course, no one really knows, Peter, how long this western city will remain a relatively safe haven.
Amelia Adams reporting to us from Lviv. Thank you.